Welcome back to Afternoon Express. So it's not every day that a member of the royal family, like Meghan Markle, for example, the Duchess of Sussex, personally selects to visit you at your place of work. And that is exactly what happened to Tshepo Mohlala, also known as Tshepo the Jean Maker. He joins us now to chat about his story from humble beginnings to ongoing success. And if you've got any questions for Tshepo, please head over to our social media platforms using the hashtag Afternoon Express. How are you? The Jean Maker is actually what I call my parents.
Really? Oh, wow. It makes so much sense. I was like, I actually wanted to say it, but I was like, tone it down.
I'm just so obsessed with you, just as obsessed with Meghan Markle. I have a piece of yours, but I've actually got an apron.
An apron.
It's the best.
And you look
apron
so
I
good. I thought you were going to wear it today.
I didn't. It's at home. It's in my cupboard. I'll wear it tonight.
But keep it, you know.
No. I'm obsessed. It's my favorite piece of clothing.
Awesome. I'm happy.
How did you get into the jean business?
It was an accident, actually. I wanted to be a cinematographer. And I found myself in fashion in film school. I realized I'm not supposed to be here. I dropped out, went to fashion school. Then I was a stylist. And I realized, like, I think for a very long time, after doing so many things in fashion, I realized, like, I've been looking for a product or a fabric could purpose.
Yeah.
And the only fabric that I could find was just denim. And the thing about denim is so nostalgic. Like I remember back in the early 2000s, my aunt used to come back home from varsity wearing like a denim on denim. And I was like, this person's so cool and I want to be like her. And growing up in Tsakane, like my mom, my grandmother was a storyteller. And for me, I wanted to be a storyteller. And I'm in fashion and it's like, well, how can I tell stories in fashion? And the only product that like resonated with me was jeans. So I started with making jeans. Started with the first range. We had 100 pairs of jeans that we made.
Amazing.
Started selling from my backpack. Yeah. Grew the business, bought a motorbike, grew the business. And then now we have an atelier at Victoria Yards where actually the Duchess of Sussex, Meghan Markle, came to visit
us. Tell me about that experience. Wasn't that incredible?
It was royal.
It was royal.
Okay. I think for us, what it did for our brand and what it did for me, it was kind of like it gave us a stamp and it just confirmed or affirmed that what we're doing is good.
Yeah.
And Tshepo, you don't know who's watching. You don't know who's talking about you. Your name has gone so far to to Buckingham Palace in London and they're like having dinner and they're talking about you. It's so amazing. So for me, it's like we're actually doing the right thing.
Yeah.
Just continue doing, continue hustling, continue creating good work. And also I think one of the things about our brand is that we concentrate more on stories than we do about the product. Like, yes, the product is good, but the story for us is the big thing. Like, we really want to tell stories.
Exactly.
And what we love doing now, we've hired ladies from bedrooms where our studios are based, and everybody is like within walking distance to get to work.
Incredible.
And for us, it's like, that's the type of story
amazing
we want to tell.
So they're keeping healthy and fit while they're
keeping,
coming to make beautiful clothes.
Absolutely.
Oh, and I really do love your stuff and I love your story. I cannot wait for you to just take to the stars because, I mean, it's happening. It's going to happen.
Absolutely, yeah.
So we've asked you if you've got any questions for Tshepo. And Mompoto Momo Mojapelo asked, where do you want to see your brand in the near future and whom do you want to work with? Watching from Polokwane, Limpopo province.
Oh, wow, that's where I come from. I come from Mpumalanga as well, Limpopo, basically. Where do I want to see myself? I think for us, it's like, I'm becoming a strong national brand, being available in every province.
Yeah.
And also, like, I think our brand is very global, has a global appeal, and just having stores across the world, that's where we see ourselves. But
exactly.
Also, like, creating jobs and creating, like, meaningful stories that people can relate to.
Well, you're in Amsterdam now already.
Yeah.
So, I mean, the world
is
your oyster.
Yeah.
Thank you for being here today.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
We love you.
Love you too.